we have recognized that when somebody buys a ticket to take a flight, particularly when they are buying it for the whole family, it's a considerable expense. Flying can be a stressful experience for some people, and it is essential to recognize that passengers, when they've bought that ticket, have certain rights. And that's why we've worked for the past 3 years to put in place a passenger rights bill that is fair and that is simple and clear. Today, phase one, we announced measures with respect to the obligation of the airlines to communicate clearly with air passengers. Secondly, compensation in cases of overbooking, which can go up to $2,400. Compensation in the case of lost or damaged baggage, which can go up to $2,100. A maximum period of time on the tarmac, which is 3 hours, and also the treatment of passengers during that waiting period, which must include access to water and food, to the bathroom, to communications, to air conditioning and heating if it's in the winter. Those are things that are absolutely essential to ensure that we minimize the discomfort of passengers when there are the odd tarmac delays. Phase one is in place. We've talked about it for a long time, but today we're actually putting it into practice. Canadians will now have the opportunity to access these passenger rights when they feel that their rights have not been respected. I was surprised, in fact, a bit disappointed that the airlines should come out challenging something that is fundamental, which is passenger rights. As you know, it will be before the court, so I'm not going to comment about it any further. But we feel that we have done our homework very, very carefully in consultation with the airlines and with other stakeholders, and we feel that the passenger rights that we've put in place are going to stand up and that they're very fair to both passengers and to the airlines.